I believe it's a calling for me to be in this field because of the joy that I get when I encounter every patient that comes through me. When you see them on day one, they look old. Some of them, they come in with walking stick. Some of them, they haven't been washed, you know, because they couldn't do things on their own. To see them the next day being able to walk without the walking stick, able to, you know, fix themselves up, the joy that I see reflecting off from them, it's something that I couldn't even describe. The guardians that they had to take care of them for this how many months, years even, for them to be able to see their loved ones walking on his or her own, you can just see the joy from their face as well. And most of them, you know, they come up to us and then they bless us with words. You feel like you've done a lot to bring change to a person and then to bring change to his family and the community. Yes, you've done a lot.
Jeffet?
In Papua New Guinea, because eye is a small specialty, it's been given less priority. So for us training, we come up with a lot of shortfalls, like starting from the smallest things like consumables. We often run out of supplies. And then you have other barriers like, you know, communication, Papua New Guinea being a diverse country, a country with a lot of, you know, different cultures and languages. COVID really affected my training. I didn't get to do a lot of surgery, so I wasn't able to proceed on to my master's. But thankfully, Medellin Hospital, with the help of Fredolos, I should say, they rescued me. They saw where I needed help, and their help was tremendous. And I could get a bit emotional talking about it because, yeah, I really love this. It's my passion. Sometimes it's overwhelming because the doctor to patient population is just too much. I've seen the need for population with a lot of increasing eye health problems. I believe we have about 12 to 15 specialists who are currently on active duty, working in each of the provinces in the country. But for the registrars, that's where the blockage is, the ones in training. I hope a lot of my juniors, they get to choose this field. It's very rewarding. You get to bring a lot of changes to not only one person, but to a family, a community, to a lot of people. The reward is nothing that you can compare it to.